Well, it looks like the Old Farts Hiking Club is off to a bad start this time. Looks like our executive committee is kind of bogged down here. Can't go forward, can't go backwards. So we're going to have to regroup and come back at a later date and retrieve Al's car.
From the county impound when the sheriff...
Yeah, the county will probably impound it and tow it off while we're hiking. Al just tried to bury his car. I don't think he wants it anymore.
Well, I was going to say, if DL doesn't have a chain, at least you'll have a gun. We can shoot it.
Yeah, we can shoot the car.
Well, we're going to go ahead and continue our hike, and we'll come back and retrieve this vehicle at a later date. Okay, we finally arrived at the trailhead. We've rode in the back of this pickup truck, seems like 20 miles. Brian was driving fast. He didn't miss any bumps.
Put that up, boy.
Careful what you say, you're on record.
This will be on YouTube tomorrow.
Push your arbor off and tear the creek bridge.
Well, it's debatable whether everybody's having fun or not. Okay, we're finally getting this hike underway. We've had a few detours and missed turns and stuck vehicles, but it'll turn out good. Looks like it's going to be a lot of pretty wildflowers and dogwoods and on this hike. Okay, we're hiking down this bike trail at present time. I don't know how far we'll go down this bike trail before we hit the trailhead. Looks like we have about 13 hikers today. Okay, we're hiking along the trail here. A little patch of dogwood is real pretty in here today. Wild honeysuckle or azalea, whatever out there. Nice little patch of wild azaleas down through here.
Oh yeah.
Powerhouse right there.
Yeah,
Got a shoe.
Bob had a little catastrophe here. The sole came loose on his shoe. We got two doctors in the bunch. Neither one of them could do surgery on that shoe.
Well, that's because my sole didn't leave my body yet.
It's because you didn't have any insurance.
Right. What I had to do is to do an emergency soleopsy on his shoe.
Yep, and it worked.
We took a string and tied it back to where it won't flop.
For now.
And it's working just like new.
Yeah, or just like you.
I got a nice little waterfall here. And right up here is some wild azalea. Real colorful in the woods today. Nice patch of little green ferns growing along this drainage. Growing here by this little old stream is a red buckeye. The flowers are beginning to fade on it. They were bright red earlier in the year. It's really pretty in here. A lot of dogwoods and azaleas. A little wild azalea blooming here. We're still trudging along here. Come up on some of these rocky outcrops. Yeah, here comes a bunch of the old farts.
When we went to the walls of Jericho, we were about 3 minutes to the end of it down, and I had a backpack on.
Just a wee rest stop.
Troops painted brownies. No, there was a whole group of people, 50 plus, retired.
Boy, this is a pretty dogwood patch right through here.
You get on your back and no sweat. And, if you don't keep the bladder clean, it gets pretty funky.
Yeah,
science experiment going on inside. Especially if you're running, you know, Gatorade or some sports drink through it.
Where's the guy with the chainsaw?
Yeah.
He's slacking off here.
guys in this thing?
Yeah.
Mark Lanny?
Yeah. Sits the wilderness. Always wanted to come back. So I retired 20 years ago and went back.
Yep.
A buddy I was in the Navy with back in around 62, he was from Portland.
Uh-huh.
He went to school there, became a lawyer, and he ran for governor a couple of times.
Charlotte Craig.
He's only like his third or fourth wife.
That was S.H. Shelby.
Yeah.
That wouldn't surprise me.
And the last one, he married a girl who was in D.C., I guess.
Pretty little azalea is growing along here. I can't say that much for these old fart hikers, though.
B.L.'s father is my patient. He's in the nursing home. I told B.L. if he ever puts out the food flag, I get there. He's in the nursing home there. He's going to discharge his daddy back to him.
Look, there's another wild azalea that's white.
Yeah.
Or, so we just saw a dogwood straight ahead. That's an azalea.
Okay, we're coming around the side of this ridge here, and it's pretty good little overlook. Can't see too well for the trees, but there's a little settlement over there. I don't know. This is a pretty little red buckeye plant. It's right on side the trail. And then down here, down this steep little old grade is a bunch more.
Came out and you wanted to get a beer. And I said,
nice little pool to swim in.
Yeah, they
put it in.
Okay, we've just came out here on this dam. This is the Terrapin Creek watershed. Someone said there's a series of three dams along the Terrapin Creek for flood control. And the trail comes right across this dam.
Yeah, the floods took it out, and you go up there and you've got all the flood control stuff.
This is beautiful.
Oh, hi there.
And over here on this side is a larger lake. Here's a bush of mountain laurel that's just beginning to bloom. In another few days, that'd be really pretty right there. We've seen a lot of pretty scenery through here. The trail goes around the top of this ridge right above the watershed lake. And pretty good sized little lake. And back around this way it goes up to the dam. Okay, some of the old farts craggling across the dam over there. We stopped here kind of waiting on them.
Yeah, we got six. Nelson and the Shoemaker are still behind, probably.
Yeah, we got six right here.
And there's five down there.
Yeah.
11, so it's still
there. Yeah, okay.
Ready to go a little more? Get a little more.
We're gone, Albert.
Bunch of big old turtles down there on that log.
Yeah. Yeah, some of them did. Some of them
well, I really can't see them here in the view. This little old lake, it comes around the bend and then goes quite a ways down here through the between these ridges, looks like. Looks like we got a couple of fishermen down here in a canoe, some kind of a boat. Can't tell if they're fly fishing. Got a couple of trail markers here. I don't know who built them. I guess this is the gateway to the Penhodie going north. Or maybe it's a memorial to a couple of dead hikers. Coming through the gates of the Penhody.
What's these rocks for, Harper?
That's Cherokee markers, I guess.
They call them Karens.
Huh?
They call them Karens.
Yeah, they're Karens.
Up to the top.
Is it not on this other guy?
Okay, we came out off of the Penhody onto County Road 500 here at Grimes Cemetery. And D.L. is back over here behind the cemetery setting up his cooking trailer. Okay, to start the morning off, first thing, Al dropped his vehicle in this bottomless pit, and we wasn't able to get it out. So we're going to have a rescue operation here shortly when we get the right equipment, see if we can retrieve his vehicle. I guess somebody declared this vehicle dead. Looks like they've put up a memorial here for it. Well, I guess somebody marked off the crime scene here. We got the road blocked. Well, everybody's off of the trail now. We're here getting ready to eat lunch. Hobo made this hike. Him and DL setting up to cook their lunch. Shoemaker's trying to get his cigar lit.
This guy, I told you, he knows Katie. That's why I brought this. Yeah, Katie has some moonshine.
I don't think so.
Katie's fried, she had fried peanuts.
Yeah, no, but she's a lightweight one on liquor, I tell you.
Never will touch mine.
Real lightweight.
That's my best.
I don't blame you.
Yeah, why is
the way she talks? You don't like to go out with women that smoke cigars.
The way she talks is fried oats.
Yeah, I've got two or three of those.
Made all the time.
Yeah.
I'll believe
you're into
potatoes.
I brought that.
And
the only reason I can't
pack it on the top is she looks just like her
brother. Is it a beer?
Yo.
Oh, man. Wait till I tell her I met
you. There are a lot more other small beers up in Pennsylvania.
Oh, she will. Absolutely.
This is great. This is
terrific.
Wait a minute.
Correct.
And also,
Cunningham. Sure. You need to sit down while you smoke that.
That's the song.
I do? Yeah, it looks better. Really?
You'll look like Winston Churchill.
All right, I can do that.
Sit up on a
German seat.
Red Solo Cup, that's it.
Oh, am I taking someone's chair?
No.
Our chair's got
to be free. November we vote.
But anyhow.
Well, I gave him the extra.
Everybody's had lunch. Sitting around here now telling tall tales.
Thank you.
No, I haven't seen it. Yeah.
That's a good movie.
Yeah.
Everybody seems to be relaxed and having a good time.
Actually, there were like 17 horses that they used.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
to Cindy's tonight.
That's all right. Cindy does not judge people.
Oh, I know.
You know, considering Brian, you can see why.
Yeah.
Well, thanks, Al.
We should have a
it's
long
right.
ride back to town.
It's very seldom do I get the best of my doc, you know.
After that moonshine.
But I got to tell you, you married good.
Yeah. Married
good.
Married good. Your flight, you done with it?
Yeah. And
there you go.
Thanks
and
a lot,
And I had that dessert all over
upside
it, too.
Down, I knew that.
Just be glad.
What do you say, huh? Huh? What do you say? That's a good boy. That's a
good boy.
You want to do that? Oh, you want to do some more?
Okay, we're beginning this rescue mission here to get Shoemaker's car out of the hole. This ought to be a fiasco if there ever been one. We got plenty of onlookers. DL's gonna try to winch him out, so. He's in a really big hole here.
That's for the insurance plan. I don't mean that. Hey Al, could you come sit in the driver's seat?
I think you're talking about the other Al. Hey Al, you're right. You
can lay into it. Lay into it.
I know. I wish I could ride it all day.
I know. That's all right. Next year you learn how to ride. All right.
Well, I bet you did.
Okay, now who's up? All right, there's Aubrey. He's got this. Yeah.
Old girl over there starting to freeze.
Yeah.
think waving got enough
everybody
picture.
Now. Wave. See you there, parade wave.
Well, looks like DL saved the day here. We've got Shoemaker out of the mud hole. If Brian don't run out of gas, we may get home before dark. Brian's running on the red light.